The next generation is about to be unveiled to the world in the wake of a showcase of the form factor of Microsoft's Xbox Series X and the emblazoned monochromatic logo of Sony's PS5. Sony has said very little about next generation, while Microsoft is laying the groundwork for a whole new Xbox platform, looking to not only make up lost ground from the Xbox One, but offer more than the competition in almost every facet with a multi-tiered approach. And right now, we will learn about what will make the Xbox Series X generation the most robust, most powerful, most consumer-friendly, and most appealing platform. This is the all-new Xbox. This is Colt Eastwood. Thanks for checking in. Today, my information comes from an article on MCV Develop, where studio lead Matt Booty laid out the entire roadmap and strategy for next generation, as well as some insight that not many know and understand that will change the way the world looks at the Xbox platform. If you're new here, like and subscribe to the channel if you appreciate this video, and let's take a look at Xbox strategy going forward. Xbox Game Studios lead Matt Booty talked about games coming to the next generation on the announced Xbox Series X console, a super powerful, top-tier hardware console that may rival many and most big gaming PCs on the consumer market. Power is very important to the launch of a generation, and when gamers upgrade hardware or consoles, they want to see the new and improved visuals and experiences. But Microsoft is doing something that most console generations have seldomly done. They plan to fully support the Xbox family of consoles with their first-party exclusives the first 1 to 2 years into the generation. This means that Halo Infinite will be fully playable on Xbox One, Xbox One S, Xbox One X, and the new Xbox Series X. Matt Booty said, "Sort of like PCs, our games will play up and down that family of Xbox devices. Our approach is to pick one or two IPs that we're going to focus on and make sure that they're there at the launch of the console, taking advantage of all of the features. And for us, that's going to be Halo Infinite. And that team is definitely going to be doing things to take advantage of Xbox Series X," end quote. This means that the Xbox One console will not be left behind as millions migrate from their current console to the next. This means that the Xbox One S and the base model launch Xbox will run Halo Infinite at 1080p 60 dynamically, and the Xbox One X from 2017 will run the new Halo Infinite game at 4K 60 dynamically, much like Halo Master Chief and Halo 5. The new Halo Infinite is built on a brand new proprietary Slipspace engine, but the game will scale across all Xbox One and Xbox Series consoles. But most importantly, the Xbox Series X will have the very best version of Halo Infinite as it was realized to be. This is a big concern for gamers with the mindset in last generation, where a clean break occurred and you left your games behind. So they closed the doors of the PS3 and the Xbox 360 and released only on new consoles for the most part. The difference now is x86 architecture. In other words, all new and current games are built in the same software language that PC, PlayStation, and Xbox speak. Just as PC games scale across the latest $1,200 graphics cards, $300 CPUs, those same games are built to run on $150 graphics cards, even older cards and older CPUs. Lower hardware does not hold back bigger and better hardware in the PC gaming space. The same is now applied to consoles. In fact, during the PS4 and Xbox One era, thousands of games shared with PC, just with lower visuals and performance on console. Here's how it works. Developers push the limits of their creativity, world building, and visual talents to make the best game they can. They work under the constraints of the median. This means that they build for minimum specs of very capable PC hardware to make games for hundreds of millions of players across console and PC. From there, they scale down to get the best look and feel on the base PS4 and Xbox One and minimum spec PC, which is usually a bit more powerful than base consoles. Fans are alight on social media right now claiming that games are being held back by base consoles. In fact, they're even going as far to say that games would be bigger and better if they didn't have to run on lower spec PCs and base model consoles. To assume that the Xbox Series X games will be held back, dumbed down, or restrained because of the Xbox One is totally backwards of how games are created. Imagine if you thought that a massive, fully realized game like God of War on the PS4 was held back because it wasn't made to run on a $1,000 PC. Games are amazing, look amazing, and next gen they will feel amazing in every aspect with faster frame rates and incredible immersive environments afforded by the extra power in the Xbox Series X. Next generation is already mostly secured for the Xbox Series X as the most powerful and capable console, but what about the games?
Xbox had no games.
Xbox Game Studios is already deep in development of some 20 plus games across 15 studios, gathering second party deals with their publishing arm and hiring top talent across the industry, even adding prominent names from Sony Studios to create games bigger than Xbox has seen in a decade. Matt Booty is leading that charge and he feels very secure going into this generation, closing out the current one with dozens of games just from the Xbox platform. Matt Booty said that we need to make sure that we hold the bar high on quality and that we're releasing games that we can be proud of and that fans can be proud of as Xbox exclusives. Right now, looking at the workflow and release window of 15 studios, Xbox is on track to deliver some 4 to 5 big titles per year, offset with more diverse games and release around 50 first-party games across the entire Xbox Series generation. Contrast that with the Xbox One, which had around 10 to 15 notable exclusives the entire generation that did not transcend. The games have to be good, the games have to be amazing, and with the talent and scope of studios on staff, Xbox Game Studios has a ton of promise. Matt Booty explained, "Every studio has its own culture, their own way of thinking, and we put a lot of energy into making sure they understand that their culture will be preserved. They'll be unique." He says, "We have done enough of that now to just shift over to working on games. We need to focus on making games. We need to keep the end goal in mind, which is to make sure we have a steady slate of games." End quote. Matt Booty explained that Microsoft's role is strictly funding and support and that they are allowing these teams to do their thing. This dissolves the misconception that Microsoft or Xbox hindered the quality of first-party games by telling them what to do or what to create. Xbox is the only platform that has laid out a handful of next-generation releases announced a year before the console even launches. Right now, they have revealed Halo Infinite, Hellblade 2 Senua's Saga, and Rare's Everwild, showing all three games this past year, with a vision to be fully realized on next-generation Xbox Series X. A fourth game is Turn 10's industry-leading racer Forza Motorsport 8, with a full extra year of funding and development time. There are rumors that the Coalition is holding off on Gears 6 to make something new and give Gears some time to breathe. Playground Games has all but confirmed that they are working on a next-generation Fable game, and of course, the upcoming Forza Horizon 5. Xbox Game Studios has 10 other studios working on their own new games, some with multiple teams. Not only will Xbox have great, fully realized games with this additional funding and support, they will have a ton of them threefold next-generation. Bringing more people to Xbox games, multiplat games, Xbox Live, xCloud, and Xbox Game Pass. All of this will reciprocate back to the Xbox Game Studios that are already busy working on a massive games for Xbox and PC, and all of this makes next generation an irresistible upgrade for holiday 2020. This is Colt Eastwood. Thank you so much for watching. I've been waiting to talk about games. Xbox has been very vocal and upfront about next generation because it seems like they're ready to close out the Xbox One generation. I've been covering in detail and in depth the specs for the Xbox Series X and the PS5, and it looks like both will be incredibly powerful and that Xbox will definitely have the power advantage, but most of you would just rather wait for official word from Microsoft and Sony, and I think that's going to be coming soon, probably in a month or two. Thank you to all of you who stuck through this video long enough. I know I had a lot to cover. If you enjoyed this video or learned something, please let me know by liking the video and subscribing to the channel. Those who really like what I do and want to support, you can become a channel member on YouTube or become a Patreon. That gives you early access to videos. Add me on Xbox Live and Twitter at Colt Eastwood. If you want to talk about gaming, I'm on there every day. This is a pretty amazing community, and we have a lot to look forward to this year with the console reveals, E3, and a whole bunch of new games. Let me know what you're most excited about for next gen and where you'll be playing. And as for the people that came here just to argue, be nice.